हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज़ लानिशा शर्मा एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट ह्यूमन हार्ट। सो ह्यूमन हार्ट इट इज़ लोकेटेड इन द सेंट्रल ऑफ द चेस्ट इन बिटवीन द लंग्स एंड जस्ट अबाउट द डायफ्राम। इट इज़ कॉनिकल इन शेप। ओके, इट वेज अराउंड 300 ग्राम्स इन मेल एंड 250 ग्राम्स इन फीमेल। इट इज़ टिल्टेड टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ आवर बॉडी, हेंस वी फील दैट आवर हार्ट इज़ लेफ्ट साइड। नो, बट इट इज़ प्रेजेंट इन द सेंट्रल बट लिटिल बिट टिल्टेड टुवर्ड्स अ left side। okay, now its size is about own tightly folded fist size। okay, it's a muscular and a pumping organ which is made up of cardiac muscle। now this cardiac muscle helps it to rhythmically contract and relax। okay, now this rhythmic contraction of the heart, it helps to pump the blood into the arteries so that it could be transported to all the part of our body। now let's learn about the internal structure of the heart। the heart, it is covered by a double-walled membranous sac called as pericardium, and it is also divided into two halves with the help of septum or partition। now each half is further divided into two। from this we can inculcate that the human heart is four-chambered heart। okay, then upper two chamber of the heart is called as atria or auricle, and the lower two chambers of the heart is called as ventricle। Right side of the heart always carries deoxygenated blood, which is also called as impure blood, and left side of the heart always carries oxygenated blood, which is also called as pure blood। There is no mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood takes place in human heart। Let's learn more about auricle or atria। Okay, now auricles are also called as receiving chamber of the blood। Okay, now why it is called receiving chamber of the blood? Let's start with right auricle। Okay, as I told you that the right side of the heart always carries or always conducts deoxygenated blood, so right auricle, it will receive deoxygenated blood from all the part of the body via superior and inferior vena cava। Okay, now what is the role of superior vena cava? So all the blood veins from the upper part of the body are combined to form superior vena cava, and same for inferior vena cava। All the veins from the lower extremities of the body, they combine to form inferior vena cava, and like this it conducts all the deoxygenated blood towards right auricle। Okay, now let's learn about left auricle। Left auricle, it receives oxygenated blood from the lungs via pulmonary vein। Now here you must be thinking that how come a vein can conduct oxygenated blood, because we know that all the vein conduct only deoxygenated blood। There is one exception, that is pulmonary vein। Pulmonary vein is the only vein which carries oxygenated blood। Okay, now the internal walls of the auricles, as they are receiving chamber of the heart, it is smooth and thin walled। Okay, now let's learn about ventricles। Ventricles are thick walled and they are rough। Right ventricle, it receives deoxygenated blood from right auricle via valves। Now what do you mean by valves? Valve is a structure which prevents the backward flow of blood। I can also define as it is a structure which allows the blood to flow only in one direction। Okay, so on the right side of the heart, between right auricle and right ventricle, there is tricuspid valve, it is also called as Eustachian valve। Okay, and from the right ventricle, the deoxygenated blood is pumped into the lungs via pulmonary artery। Now what is pulmonary artery? Pulmonary artery is artery, but we know that all the arteries carry oxygenated blood। Now why this pulmonary artery is carrying deoxygenated blood? This is the exception। All the artery except for pulmonary artery carries oxygenated blood। Fine, now left ventricle। Left ventricle, it receives oxygenated blood from left auricle via bicuspid valve। Bicuspid valve, it is also called as mitral valve। Okay, now once the blood is received by left auricle, it will be pumped, as it is a oxygenated blood, it will be pumped in the force towards aorta, which is the largest artery of our body, which is also guarded by semilunar valve, and via which the oxygenated blood will be transported to all the part of the body with the help of different arteries. Okay, so that's all. Thank you. I hope you like my lecture.